Hello everyone, welcome back to The Negative. In this video, we're going to be discussing stand development, what exactly it is, what are their pros and cons, and would I recommend it. Stand development requires a very dilute developer, usually like 1 to 100, and most often people use Rhodanol, and it's usually developed for at least an hour, between an hour and 90 minutes. So it's an extended development time with minimal agitation. So once you do your initial agitation, you pretty much let it set for the entire duration of the development, with the exception of one tilt like halfway through, just to minimize the streaking that you can get from stand development. So one of the first reported benefits of stand development is a speed increase, meaning that you can get more shadow detail with less light. In my experiment, I did notice the speed increase, although it's only like maybe half a stop, so it's not really gonna save your image if it's severely underexposed. So this is Ilford FP4 exposed at 200. The stand development is on the left and normal development is on the right. I wanted to see if you could actually tell a speed increase with the stand development. The shadows on the left with the stand development are a tiny bit lighter, so it does look like it picked up a little bit of speed, but it's pretty negligible, so it's not much. Another one of the benefits to stand development is the adjacency effect, which is basically the separation of details in small areas. So if you look at the left side, which is a stand developed image, the fuzz on the peaches looks a lot sharper, and that's due to the edge effects from the stand development. With Rhodanol being a high Accutance developer, you get a lot more of these edge effects, which when there's changes in tonality, it appears much sharper to your eye because the contrast has a more of a separation between dark and light. You can get some cases though where the Accutance is so high that you get sort of a haloing effect, and depending on the image, this can sort of ruin the image. As you can see here, it is so extreme that it looks like the edge of the building is glowing. This is a lot more common with smaller formats like medium format or especially 35mm. It's not going to be so apparent in large format, but it is something to be mindful of. You can significantly reduce these haloing and streaking effects by preparing a water bath. So the change in temperature over the duration of the development is actually what's going to cause some of those effects. So to reduce these effects, the best way to do that is to prepare a water bath of 20 degrees Celsius, place it inside one of these coolers, and you're going to keep your film in there for the duration of the development, and that's going to significantly reduce those effects. In conclusion, I do like stand development. It is pretty interesting to try something different, and I do like the effects, although in this instance for me they were kind of minimal. I think the adjacency and edge effects can be pretty cool depending on the image, but I definitely think it's not for everything. So I would like to experiment with it more in the future. And yeah, I would recommend it. I think you guys might enjoy trying this out. So let me know in the comments, are you guys fans of stand development? Or if you haven't tried it, would you ever be willing to try it? If you found this video to be enjoyable or helpful, please give it a like. And we'll see you guys next time on The Negative.